Dear students, welcome and thank you for tuning in. We are still discussing the mechanics of materials lab number 5, which is 3-point bending, talking about the calculations that you need to do for your report. In this video, I'm going to explain the second requirement, which is calculating the elastic flexural strength from the data that you have. We calculate the maximum elastic bending moment at the mid-span in the previous video. In this video here, we're going to calculate the elastic flexural strength. Remember that this is an elastic flexural strength. So this is the force that is at the top of the elastic region. So if you have this as your force deflection curve or data, you need to find the flexure strength at the proportional limit where we move from the elastic region to the plastic region. Here's how we're going to do it. We have this formula for sigma max. So this is the strength, which is the stress in 3-point bending. So it is MC over I, where M is the moment, which we calculated from the previous video, which is the maximum elastic bending moment. So that's M. C is the distance between the neutral axis and the one of the edges of your rectangular specimen. This is our thickness, which is H. So C is H over 2. And I is the moment of inertia. And this is how we calculate sigma. If you remember from the tensile testing, sigma was calculated as a stress by dividing the force divided by the cross-sectional area. Because it's a 3-point bending, we are using the moment multiplied by the distance from the edge to the neutral axis divided by the moment of inertia. C is H over 2. M, we calculated it from the previous video, which was FL divided by 4. Then you need to find I, which is the moment of inertia. So this is a simplification of the formula. So FLH divided by 8I. So the moment of inertia for a rectangular shape is given by this formula. B, which is the width of the specimen, H cube, which is the thickness divided by 12, and you can find that from the textbooks, and we can calculate it actually if you go back to your statics class. If we want to plug I in here, it will be 3FL divided by 2BH square. So this is F, this is the force at the proportional limit, right, which is here at this point. L is the length of the specimen, B is the width of the specimen, H is the thickness, and if you go back to your data and you selected a point here and you plugged all the values, you will end up with 1.81 gigapascal, which is the flexural strength for the specimen that we have and that we gave to you. And this is how you calculate the elastic flexural strength. So keep in mind, this is a strength, so it's stress, and it's elastic, so it's the top of the elastic region. And flexure, this is 3-point bending test, and that's how you calculate it. So I hope that you will be able to extract the data from, everything is given actually, except F that you need to calculate you need to extract from the data that was given to you. Thank you for watching, and till the next video. Bye.